Hello, Gunner here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We have arrived at the catacombs on merciless difficulty. So we have to do a trial here in order to prove ourselves worthy to face down Izaro at some point in the not too nearby future. We'll probably keep it at that. I mean, Cruel Labyrinth was the one that I was really looking forward to. Merciless is just a bonus. The build is relatively straightforward in that regard. See, a prophecy has triggered, so we can look forward to finding a Tora here that will want our help. We'll get a triple experience for that. That's quite a bit. Especially this early on, that's probably going to be a full level or something. But first, a trial. It's the death room, boss. It's the room boss of doom, the doom boss. That does sound funny enough. But so far, I haven't really been hit by them. Something is wrong. Game, what are you doing? Why am I not hit yet? I'm usually terrible at kiting these things. Exactly. That's what I was expecting. The game never disappoints. If you expect to die, well, not die, but expected to get hit, that helps.
Hope Hello. In the left hand, surety in the right.
But normally I would call it quits here. But in this case, we have to look forward to Tora, otherwise we have wasted a perfectly good prophecy. This is a level 67 area, that's why some of the white items have outlines around them. Because those are the highest tiers of a certain items that can drop. Now for builds that I have been playing, I have added some outlines to the loot filter. Just manually going through the wiki. This outlining was useful and not. I realize I probably should have switched to one of someone else's filters at some point in the past. Because due to the simple fact that I didn't have to do it myself then, just the wiki crawling and things like that. On the other hand, my setup has now been so customized to my own liking that, you know, I probably wouldn't like using someone else's loot filter. Because what I value might not be what someone else values, and vice versa. Okay, I realize I kind of accepted Tora's quest without looking, and I have no idea. Well, we have to hunt down the infected beasts. Most of the time, there's more than one. So, well, yeah, if we find some of them, then usually they drop puddles or something. That will allow you to track the next set. So we're just gonna go with that. Let's see, there's a lot of stuff down there. Let's have a look. So far, no monsters, nothing corrupted, that's odd. Makes me wonder if I'm not going completely the wrong direction. Ooh, platinum Chris, what's that precious? Mark of the Doubting Knight, increased global crit chance, additional block chance while dual wielding, 240% increased physical damage. That's a huge amount. Reduced attack speed, elemental resists, melee crits have a 25% chance to cause some bleeding and a 25% chance to poison. If you dual wield those, that's pretty cool. They get a 25% block chance, 50% chance to bleed and poison, and a ton of damage. Interesting. The daggers though, that's the annoying bit. So I couldn't use this on my lacerator even if I wanted to. Because that is indeed what my thoughts just went to. Like inflicting status ailments, you say. Ah, there is the corrupt punch. Whoa. Chill out. Really? Chill out. That's a rather serious amount of explosions. So just burn that one down. Weeping Essence of Greed. But to come back to the previous topic, lacerate can only work with swords and axes, and well, a dagger is not a sword nor an axe. You could use it in offhand and then combine it, that would work. Then you would only use your main hand for the lacerate attacks and it would just ignore your offhand. I think that could work. And there is the rest of the corrupting stuff. Just flammability them. And they'll just burn themselves out. Two, three. Yeah, they're all here. Just have to look for them. Okay, one more. So now we're running back to Tora, who was all the way on the other side of the map. And then we'll just simply portal out, because we did find the waypoint of the enclosing area. There's Tora. Let's see, then we have to kind of navigate around for a little bit. Go through here, then through there. Just jump a couple times, and then hello, Tora. You are very grateful.
Smelling of beast and blood. A master hunter seeks aid.
Okay. And then we just stash our stuff. Oh yeah. After the last episode, I went through all the items that I had been collecting from the recording of two episodes. And I found this pretty nice shield. I crafted additional armor on it, but even without the percentage bonus and without the quality, it had like 600 something base armor. So our shield now does more, has more armor than our body armor, and as a result we are at 9500. Points of armor, which is a rather significant amount. So we are getting there. We don't even have a granite flask or a flask that increases our armor percentage. We're not really heavily focusing on increasing our total amount of armor. Nor are we running a determination aura, and we already have nearly 10,000. So I think in terms of now focusing on armor and defenses, we're doing a pretty good job here. Just a good tower shield and a decent body armor will get you quite a lot. And as a marauder, it's kind of impossible not to get bonuses to armor, so no, there's no real conscious effort, but you will pick up the notes anyway. And we've arrived in the battlefront. So this is our passage into the docks. The docks, we have two items to grab. Here we also have one item to grab, and then eventually we're gonna have a visit into the Solaris Temple. Have a chat with the Gemling Queen, Lady Diala. And she's gonna be really happy. And she's gonna open up her laboratory to us. Oh, we're level 65. So we are progressing through the content pretty quickly. I think that after the first map we run, we will, as a guarantee, get Zana. So I'm curious to see if there's any new things to the dialogue, if the first mission or something, if there's something special to it. Because no, they did a complete revoiceover of Zana. As you have noticed by playing yourself and from the Toxic Viking videos. No, different voice actress, there's actually a bit of a storyline now, it all focuses on the Shaper. So it's all good. But, of course, the Viking already had Zana encounters, because it's Standard League and I've had maps access there for quite a while. Here, news new league, we don't. So of course, I'm very curious to see what they've done for the very, very, very first encounter with Zana. Because she used to tell stories about, I think, you know, shipfaring with her father, and that's why she had a fascination with maps. But of course, these are not quite the maps you're looking for. These are maps of a different nature. Okay, I'm just gonna release the Army of the Damned, just because. Because we are, well, pretty much near to the end of the area, and it's kind of a waste to keep charges if you're gonna leave the area. So here, our goals will be getting the waypoint and getting the automatic sulfite. Killing the boss also useful, but not a strict requirement, but most of the time you will encounter the boss way before you encounter any of the other objectives. Well, the so-called objectives. It's not strictly objectives, it's more something that's nice to do. Oh yeah, and we should have a chat with Fairgrace in order to give him the counter spiritus. Get rid of it. So it's kind of clogging up the inventory. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. Burn more of them. So there's a rather stark difference between just how quickly mobs burn up in Righteous Fire and just how visibly they burn with Searing Bond. Searing Bond currently is listed at almost 6400 points of damage. So you can imagine Righteous Fire is just going over 10,000 or something already. And that's excluding flammability and any other kind of bonuses. I really am curious to see how high we can boost it. And I think there are some lookup tables to see what the totem life is going to be, at least the base life of totems. And because Righteous Fire, of course, burns for a percentage of life, it's going to burn for a percentage of totem life, which scales with the base level of the spell totem support gem. So in this case, it requires level 58, so it's going to cost a level 58 totem. Even though we are in a level 64 area, the level is falling slightly behind, but eventually it will catch up. Now the upside, of course, of it being slightly behind is that there is still more damage that we can get in a rather cheap and inevitable way. What's the listed totem on damage on Shockwave? Oh, it's nearly 2000. But I think I saw an essence. Yes, I did saw an essence. Whispering Essence of Woe. Let's just curse you. grab it, then we get out again. At this point, essences are, they're losing their newness, their shininess. They just, click, click, grab, and we move on. And the stash full of essences, it's slowly accumulating things, and I'm already starting to convert some of the essences that I've got four of into just one of the higher tiers. Why four and not one? I guess when I've got three of them, that is of course to keep the one we already have. So it basically acts as an outline, so you will remember where everything is. So we have this. We forgot to tag the Battlefront waypoint. That's slightly annoying. Means there is nothing to jump back to. But well, sloppiness, it happens. Most of the time you come across it, I didn't even think to specifically look for it. Right, we've been there, we've been there, we've been there, then there's only one way forward, and that is here. And we have enough Quicksilver flasks, charges to do something useful again. And that is more Quicksilver, that's good. Ooh. You, yeah, I'm good, good. It is nice to just cast the totem, the shockwave totem at a remote location. This is rather annoying. We're just gonna actually grab the boots, drop the claw, just drop a random item, and then leave it behind. We empty our pockets and then we're gonna go. Well, I think we actually have enough time to make a walk towards the Solaris Temple. Get rid of this stuff that's cluttering up our inventory. We can't go here, so we have to go back through the docks and we pick up the item. That's okay. Then we run back to the start. Would be nice if we encountered another juicy pack of monsters. Hey, a boss with a juicy pack of monsters. How convenient. Here. Maybe we should just put everything next to each other. Just burn through it. That works rather well. Burn through these. Burn through those. Ooh. Nice, nice. They actually drop something. Because then we have a Quicksilver to use for running. We have a door to run back to. Battlefront. Oh yeah. Hey, waypoint, waypoint, waypoint. Where are you? We can actually get up here. Nice. Ooh, ghost. That went rather quickly. But, well, ghost. Possession, explosion, victory. And everybody says whoosh. Question is, how far do we have to backtrack in order to get the waypoint, or am I just gonna ignore it? I think I'm just gonna ignore it. There's not often a strict reason for wanting to go here. I don't believe there are quests tied to unlocking waypoints on Merciless this time, so it's lower difficulties, not here. So we can just move on and get to the Solaris Temple. And then Solaris 2 is going to be good enough for us.
This is the Eternal Way, pretty and lifeless.
The Eternal Way. Another essence over there. Level 64. So one of the side effects of going to maps is of course that we will get access to map specific essences. Which is, well, something that I'm also interested in to see what exactly that is. I think the chaos one might be there. It seems like the kind of thing that you would want to put on maps only to reward people for doing that content. So that's another map. Actually, we're finding a decent amount of maps already. We got 4 of them, so doing pretty good. Of course, this character I'm focusing on the right hand side of the map. So the crystal ore that we found there probably gonna be turned into gem cutters or the map chisels, because they are for the left side of the map. And once, well, if we actually manage to make it to the shaper and do the fight there, and afterwards maybe I'll do the other maps as well if there's an achievement or something tied to it. But no, at first I'm just gonna focus on the right hand side of the map, because the Toxic Viking is focusing on the left hand side of the map. And that way both series have different maps, and then it's, well, to prevent them from just overlapping and just being repeats of each other. I felt that would be a nice way to do it. Those were the two tapestries. They always go down rather quickly. Well, I don't remember them that they used to go down, but that's probably because my bow builds were a bit less powerful. And of course, monster deaths kind of scale down as your power goes up. We have a Searing Bond over here, so that's now nearly 7300 life damage per second. Not life per second, we don't want to heal them, we want to kill them. Again, nothing personal, but we are a hero and we kill tapestries. Yeah, I'm kind of wondering where this went weird. And that is the next area. Now we will be looking for the Goddess of Purity, who is taking a bath somewhere nearby. And of course we are gonna interrupt that. Yeah, we kind of have to. Yeah, the more I start looking at exactly what we do, the more question marks appear whether we are truly the hero of the story. But then again, it was a quest. We were just doing it. It was a quest. That makes us a hero by definition. Topper flask. This league we don't have a lot of utility flasks yet, so that's useful. Woe and Wraith. Double essences is good. I believe we can get up to 4 at some point. So that's gonna be fun. So these were just the level 60 versions. It's a tier 3, yeah. Okay, and yeah, this is not where Goddess. Oh Goddess, where the heck are you? You're not a goddess. Galvanic ribbon. Burned it to a crisp. Ah, there she is. Hello. Knock you off your pedestal. Also, here. Have some skeletons. It is time for that time when we We have all our gems suddenly decide they want to level up together. So they do that. Let's see, intelligence I think is what we are focusing on, so we'll grab that. We get Infernal Talk and the Eternal Laboratory, it opens. So let's go grab our waypoint. Cool, cool. And nothing has changed. Oh, there's a lore here. Malachi's journal.
Tear down the walls that imprison the mind. That is what the gems do. That is their true virtue. The moment my fingertips brushed the cool, silken planes of that first gem, I felt it. My skull ached as if its contents were growing, pressing against the bone, searching for a way to break free. That night, once the wine had dulled the pain enough to allow the onset of sleep, the dreams began. I have not been without them since. Nor would I be. Every spark of thaumaturgy that I wield, every device that I forge, every creature that I transfigure, I owe to these lessons cloaked in nightmare. From whence do these precepts hail? Certainly not the mundane grey between my ears. I possess only one reference that bears faith. Translated with unquestionable clarity by that idiot savant, Isius Pirandus, the beast. Duryani of the Vow knew the truth. Soon now, so shall I. Malachi.
Isius Pirandus. That's a reference I haven't heard before. I think it will, we will finish a quest line by actually going after a General Gravicy, so Gravicius, however you want to pronounce that one. Yes, it's Gravicius, but I guess the New Zealand pronunciation is similar to the American pronunciation, where they drop some letters. Oh, as reference, aluminium versus aluminum. We'll take out the general. Ooh, dying anguish. That's we're getting quite some of those. Well, we need 8. I think we're up to 4 or 5 now. Getting even more. Okay. Not complaining about that. In fact, a level 19 gem, if it's a useful one, why not?
You've forgotten your place, Karui slave.
Here, burn, print please. There you are. There you are. All the totems around you, burn you.
Who do you fight for, exile?
And then we can truly go back and celebrate. Ooh, Azamite Tower Shield. That's the best of the offerings. That's good. Have a look. Oh, see, 40% increased armor and lower base. This is not worth going for. Might as well sell it. The other things we'll do it later. Geiger, you got some skills for us. Don't you? I am getting confused here. We need to kill piety first. So, no skill points. That's too bad. Well, then let's call this an episode. And the next episode, we're gonna go kill piety and get ourselves some skill points, shall we? Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.